playground, a schoolyard, and the book had been ripped in half. Someone had taken this book and actually ripped it in half. And this devotee, to be, picked the book up. He didn't even know why he picked up half of the book. And after about 50 more yards across the playground, he found the other half of the book. And he put it together. And I remember the Sunday he came to the St. Louis Temple. He said, "Shave me up. I want to join you guys." And so the three months we had, the bliss was just flowing. And now here is Gurudev has giving us an opportunity to revive the spark again. Because for a while I thought it was gone. I thought that we would never again have another opportunity to serve such a great Mahabhagavat, to be inspired again to live, to do something selflessly, just like a cow, they're so selfless. They eat a little grass, they walk around in the field, they give us milk, which we make cheese, butter, ghee, all these good things, they clog up our arteries. But at any rate, we have to be selfless like this. What Srila Prabhupada wanted us to be. And if we're going to really say that we're followers of Srila Prabhupada and followers of Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayana Maharaj, we have to take up the mission of their line. Their line is rescuing the conditioned souls. Srila Prabhupada told us that this is the Brahma Sampradaya. Brahma Sampradaya means to give information, disseminate. So just try and take this thing, try and understand it. Even a little bit if you can understand. Prabhupada gave the example of a little girl, Saraswati. All she knew how to say was, "Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead." Prabhupada said, "This was a perfect preaching. A perfect preaching." So I want to close with one verse from Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Garhika acharya rupiloma mojim nath karino sadhu sangha loyi sadhu desha anyuta desha e buro maya rana. Garhita acharya rohilama moji means he's taking the position of a fallen householder, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, to enlighten us in our position, explaining that as a householder, I was fallen and I never wanted to associate with the sadhus. Sometimes I amazed in a group of the sadhus, but he was saying, I never wanted to associate. Garhita acharya rohilama moji, no karino sadhu sangha. Loi salvation. And then I put on the clothes of a sadhu. Ani upadesh. And then I want to instruct others. Let me put on the clothes of a sadhu. And then I instruct others. Hey, Boro Mayuranga. That is Maya's big joke. So I apologize to you for being a joke of Maya. Still, I pray for all your mercy. I pray for the mercy of Srila Prabhupada, for our entire Guru Varga, and pray that somehow or another, some way, Srila Prabhupada said, you should become determined. I remember in 1976, he said this in Vrindavan. He said, you should become determined that at some point in time, we will become determined. So we have become determined to become determined that somehow or another, we're going to get out of this material world. I follow the instructions of the
Bhakti Vedanta Swami Chinamine नास्ते सरस्वती देवं गौरवाणी प्रसन्ने निर्विशेष सुंदरवाणी पासत्या दशतरिमे नमो विष्णु बलाय गौर प्रस्थाय भूतले शिशिमा भक्ति प्रमोदाय पुरी गोस्वामी नमने Primero que todo, quiero ofrecer mis respetuosas reverencias a mi Harina Diksha Guru, mi Devita Pravishna, Om Vishnupal Paramahansa Vishnupal, Sila Sila Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, Nidhalila Pravishna, Om Vishnupal Paramahansa Vishnupal, Sila Bhakti Pramod Prigo Swami Maharaj, y mi más querido Diksha Guru, presente, Sila Han pasado 31 años desde la partida de mi amigo Martín Salvador de Arriba de las tres clases.
Of all Kivas from the three modes of material nature.
Quien nos avivó este conocimiento de nuestra verdadera identidad. Libera su pajo en intercristianidad.
He brought us the knowledge of our real identity, the identity of the soul, libera su pajo en intercristianidad.
Qué fortuna tenemos, y todavía menos yo no le aviso. Qué atraso, qué pereza. Manda su manda material, es la tendencia de la era de Cali.
We are very fortunate, and I'm most fortunate than anyone because I realize now what is our tendency, how lazy we are. Manda su material, what's the tendency of the conditioned soul?
Mi falta de memoria. De no pensar que a cada paso, padam padam, tabi padam materna.
My memory is so vague, always forgets. Padam padam.
Hay un peligro de no estar al lado de nuestra fuente de conexión.
And we are always in danger to forget the source of our connection.
Y como si la duda explicó en relación a las varas maharas, que la causa de su problema no fue eso. Sino el de no estar debidamente asociado.
The Mahaprabhu, Gurudev recently explained that the reason why Mahaprabhu fell down wasn't his attachment for the ear, but because he wasn't in a good association, he wasn't in good satisfaction.
Harinam es muy potente, pero no es más potente como cuando uno lo canta bajo la guía de un devoto puro.
Harinam is very powerful, but it is not as powerful as when one chants it under the guidance of a pure devotee.
Durante años estuvimos fuertes e inspirados al lado de nuestro artista y sacudir sin la palabra.
For so many years we feel inspired and strong under the guidance and direction of our teacher, six gurus, so Prabhupada.
Él era nuestro bhakti narsak, nuestro guardián de la devoción.
He was our guardian of devotion and path raksha.
Nosotros vivíamos una vida de sannyasi, brahmachari, y algunos vijasa. Pero después de que partió, abandonamos la idea de seguir en la misión debido a la falta de buena asociación.
Some of us were living the life of brahmachari, some vijasa, some sannyasis, but after his departure, due to the lack of association, we lost our strength.
Y sus instrucciones se volvieron en nuestras casas de manera pasiva.
And his instructions became like a having a passive role in our daily lives.
Gurudev reveló el significado primera vez de presencia del pranam mantra de nuestro Srila Prabhupada. Y con anticipo pidió a varios hermanos espirituales su significado en el Acha en el año 2000.
In a large year 2000, Gurudev gave the real meaning of our Srila Prabhupada's pranam mantra after first asking some of our brothers to explain its true meaning.
Namaste Saraswati Devan, Pero él le dio énfasis a qué es Gora Bani para Sarima.
He is pressed on the point about the meaning of what is Gaudavani Pracharya.
Y fue allí donde se encuentra el ingrediente expansivo de su organización. Y es allí donde podemos tener un entendimiento más amplio de cuál es la misión de nuestro Srila Prabhupada.
It is in these words that the active ingredients of his mission lie.
Guru Parampara, Vaishnava, Vaishnava, written two verses, so I'm excited. Although I'm qualified to do it. Tabacharana Sharamyo Shabdhaya Piti Sevyo Nitya Devyo Nityanto Sovamano Samsare Kama Krodha Vinasho Prema Dhamma Prakasho Abhaya Priya Padabjo Bhakti Vedanta Swami. Your feet are worthy of taking shelter and worthy of loving service to the Sushatana. Those feet are forever in transcendence as they dance and beautify this world of birth and death. They thus destroy the enemies headed by lust and anger and reveal the Lord's abode where love is the sole medium for interaction. Guru Nishta Prabalena Gora Shakti Makarsaya Kata Jiva Nistaraya Prabhupada Namaste. To your intense Guru Nishta, your Guru Dev, you invoked through your service the potency of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Still know that I bow down and dedicate myself to your service, for you have delivered the conditioned soul from bondage. Our Srila Prabhupada, as we've heard, one of his principal desires was to create bhavanas. The word bhavana is derived from the Sanskrit word breathe, meaning to expand. So a bhavana means one is broad-minded, as compared to Vedika, in contrast to the kripana, the small-minded person. So here, generally the brahmana is being under the threat of brahmana, janatikati brahmana, one who knows Brahma is Brahman. So this is the revolution in the sense of showing how the living entities can be broad-minded by seeing avidyavinya sampani brahmani gavi hastini, seeing all living entities in a universal fashion. It's very difficult because we're down to this Ahamkar, the Mudatma Kartam Vimanyate. I am the doer. And we're in this very small enclosure, this material body, mind, and senses. So, this is Prabhupada's gift to the world, to open the minds of people, to see beyond the duality of even Kolar, to see, instead of this thinking in terms of I and mine and my country, to bring the unity and diversity, to break open the shackles, the bondage, which is keeping us from really experiencing any happiness at all. So I thank you for this opportunity.
Pranam, Sivasya Gurudev, 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 Sivasya Gurudev have this opportunity to talk today, and I was thinking what to write, so be brief. But I could. There's so many qualities that Srila Gurudev Prabhupada presented and showed us, not only to me, but many Go brothers and Go sisters. He's directly God himself. When I joined, actually, it was 1973. I already heard the Maha Mantra. It was when I was 14 years old that I came back from school, and my mother said, oh, there is this new play in town. I was born in Buenos Aires. And the name of the play was Hair. And in that play, they were showing a slide of what's going on in New York City at that time. So of course the devotees were chanting the Maha Mantra. So my mother heard it on the radio and she said, I think this song is wonderful. I think it means happiness. You have to hear this. So later on, of course, you know, and this is just about 1 year after Srila Prabhupada arrived in New York. So imagine the potency, the power of this great personality. We have the Beatles, Rolling Stones, all our heroes of that generation. At that time, the world was pretty dark. The religions were either Christian, Jewish, or Muslim. In Argentina, actually, the government said that the official religion was Christianity. So I was raised, my father was Jewish, my mother was Catholic, but I was raised Catholic. And since I was a child, I said, well, I must have missed out because I so much like the pastimes of Lord Jesus Christ, but I see the churches, they got everything, but they can't explain. Everything is a secret. So whether it's the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, which later on Prabhupada explained it so well. So when I was 6 years old, I had to prepare for what they call the First Communion. And they teach you what is called catechism. And where they speak about the soul. So I always ask, where is the soul and what is the soul? And the teachers say, oh, somewhere in the body, there's a soul. And if you're good, you'll go to heaven. That wasn't enough. By the time I was 11 years old, I didn't want to be confirmed. My mother's family came from a line of Spanish lords, and they founded churches in Argentina. And through the years, somehow or other, my great-great-grandfather passed away, and the line stayed on my grandmother's great-grandmother's side. She lost everything. Only a little bit of land left. They have the Virgin Mary, and they have, my mother said, what kept us is that we have faith in God and we love Him. But I always ask her, where is God and what does He look like? If you go to the Sistine Chapel and the great Michelangelo, he's showing an image of God. He said it's like human, but actually it's an old man touching humans and creating the semblance of His image. So you can imagine, my search was always that I wanted to come to India. Since I was little, they asked me, what do you want to be when you grow up? I said, an archaeologist. Only because there was such a pull to come to this holy land. But I didn't know, really, what I was looking for. I knew it was the divine, but I didn't know. So I made it all the way in 1971 to Berkeley. My father said, I'll give you a ticket if you gather some money and come and attain yourself there. That was the first time I came in contact with the VTG and Samprasadam. I think it was Kangana Nayan Prabhu that gave me the first VTG. And wherever I went to, the devotees were there. Whether it was New York and then all the way to London, they were there. And this was in just very few years, Prabhupada imagined this power of this great personality to infuse this enthusiasm on people and that had given up the society, but we didn't have a solution for it. So coming back to Argentina, again searching and thinking, well, I don't like violence, so maybe I'll just go live in the land. And but as I come out of the subway, I meet the sannyas. And I say, oh, I know you, I'm Hare Krishna. I say, yes. And so I said, what are you doing here? He said, oh, I'm looking for paint to build a temple. So he gave me a card with the Maha Mantra, and I took him to the hardware store and he bought paint. That was Hanuman Prabhu, it was a sannyas. So many stories, and I don't want to make it too long, but by November, this is May 73, by November I have first Ayanam, and Srila Prabhupada said in 6 months he can have Diksha. But it so happened that the temple president and sannyas became my brother-in-law, which was a big scandal. And the three of us, my sister, who was very famous in the palaces, we went to see Srila Prabhupada. And now Gurudev, Prabhupada says, Prabhupada says, Srila Prabhupada failed me, but I committed great offense to you. He said, no, no, that's all right. Now you're two, you preach double. Everything was emphasis on preaching. Prabhupada didn't care what status we're at. Everything was emphasis on preaching. And I had edited 3 books, but I felt so ashamed of myself that I couldn't speak. Prabhupada kept asking me to come closer to him. And then I realized that what he wanted was to see the 3 books. And when he got hold of them, and I was as close as I am now to Gurudev, he read the title, perfect, in Spanish. So I thought, oh, he speaks Spanish. And then he looked at me, he always read my mind. And so he said, he quoted a verse, which I don't remember. But he said, oh, Krishna speaks even the verse language. So like that. And the next time when I'm in 1975, when finally got Diksha, oh, another long story. I was called to Prabhupada's room and he gave Diksha. He called us to his room one time, it was night, it was about 10:30 at night. And he said, Hanuman Prabhu, he said, you know Prabhupada, I don't get along too well with my god brothers. At that time, because they had left sannyas, they were taking his song. Srila Prabhupada didn't like the song, and he wanted everybody to preach everywhere. So we are alone, there are about two of us, Srila Prabhupada, and I think his servant is about almost 11 o'clock at night. And Prabhupada said, yes, I didn't get along with mine either. And he counted in his hands, he went like this, and he says, I met my Guru Maharaj only about 10 times. And then he got very grave, and he said, but I follow his instructions. So now you go on and do this. So Hanuman said, but Srila Prabhupada, when you're gone, whom am I going to? Who will I go to and follow? You want anybody in particular to be guru? And Prabhupada said, no, I want all of you to come to standard. But if you have doubt, go to the Vaishnava. Your heart tells you to. Years went by, and I know when I met Srila Gurudev that this is the Vaishnava, my heart tells me to go to. So thank you, Gurudev. Thank you, Srila Prabhupada, for all your years. You brought me to India.
हम लोग आज भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज जी के शिक्षण कमलों में इन लोगों ने पुष्पांजलि दी है और those who have not given Pushpanjali collectively from all I'm taking and I'm getting in the lotus feet of Srila Bhakti Vedanta. I pray this to be merciful to all. All the devotees, that our Krishna, bhakti is আমাদের পরম পূজ্যপাদ নিত্যলীলা প্রবেশ বিষ্ণুপাদ দশোত্তর সরস্বত ভক্তি রূপ সিদ্ধান্তি মহারাজের কালকে আমরা কামে বলে যাব, সন্ধ্যা পর্যন্ত লেগে যাবে। এই জন্য আজকে আমরা তাহার চরণে পুষ্পাঞ্জলি দেওয়ার প্রয়াস করছি। তিনি অল্প বয়সেতে মঠে আসেন প্রভুপাদের কাছে, কলেজে পড়াই আমি ফিনিশ করেন নাই, এসে দেখলেন যে তাহার নাম ছিল তখন তার নাম ছিল সিদ্ধেশ্বর ব্রহ্মচারী প্রভুপাদজি। তিনি দেখলেন যে সব বড় বড় পণ্ডিত এখানে দেন, কেউ সাধারণ লোক নয়, আবার বাড়ি চলে যান আর সেখানে ল করতে আসবে। আমাদের গুরু মহারাজের বন্ধু ছিলেন, বয়সে ছোট, তো গুরু মহারাজ দেখলেন যে সে তো আর ল পড়ছে, আবার ল হয়ে বকি অথবা কিছু হবে, আবার সংসারের মধ্যে থেকে যাবে, এই জন্য তিনি অনুসরণ করেন তার বাড়িতে। তাকে নানারকম ভাবে কথা বুঝিয়ে সুঝিয়ে আবার ঘরে নিয়ে আসলেন আবার প্রভুপাদের নিকটে। এই জন্য পরম পূজ্যপাদ রূপ সিদ্ধান্তি মহারাজ গুরু মহারাজকে খুব আদর দিলেন। তিনি মঠে আসার বাল্যকাল থেকে দুঅবস্থা থেকে বড় কুশাগ্রী স্পষ্ট বক্তা, কোন সময় দেবী মহারাজ পূর্ব বাংলাতে প্রচারে গিয়েছিলেন, সেখানে বিরাট সভা, দেবী মহারাজ বললেন সিদ্ধেশ্বর ব্রহ্মচারীকে যে তুমি কিছু বল, তিনি উঠে সিধা সাদা ভাবে বিবেকানন্দ স্বামী আর রামসাগর মানে রবীন্দ্রনাথ ঠাকুর, এদেরকে মতকে খণ্ড বিখণ্ড তুমি করবে। তখন তো লোক ছিল রবীন্দ্রনাথ ঠাকুর আর বিবেকানন্দের প্রতি মানে প্রাণ ভরা লোক, ও বাংলাদেশে তো খুব আদর তাহাতে গৌরী মঠে তত প্রচার ছিল না। তারা তিনি বললেন যে বিবেকানন্দ বিবেকানন্দ ভারতীয় সংস্কৃতের কথা পশ্চাতে বলে নাই, তাহাদের পীঠ এইখানে এসেছে আমেরিকাতে জিরোর উপরে শূন্যের উপরে এক ঘন্টা বক্তৃতা দিয়েছে আর সব লোক পাগল হয়ে জগৎ শূন্য শূন্য থেকে হয়েছে শূন্যের মধ্যে মিশে যেয়েছে। আর রবীন্দ্রনাথ ঠাকুর কেবলমাত্র গীতাঞ্জলি ওটাই আমাদের গীতা কয়েকটি শ্লোকের পারপার তার মধ্যে দিয়েছেন আর জগতের মধ্যে নম্বর প্রাইজ পেলেন। তিনি কোন ভারতীয় সংস্কৃতি প্রচার করেন না, তিনি রাজারাম ওদেরই মত তিনি জগতের প্রচার করেছেন। কোনো আত্মধর্মের কথা মধ্যে এরা দুজনই কেউ বিবেকানন্দ অথবা রবীন্দ্রনাথ ঠাকুর জানেন, এই জন্য ওনাকে রামসাগর ওনাকে বিবেকানন্দ বলতে সভায় একেবারে বিগড়ে গেল। আমরা শুনতে চাই তখন নবী মহারাজ বলেন তোমাদের সভা বন্ধ করে দিল, প্রভুপাদ কাছে দিলে বিরাট সভা হয়েছিল, বেশ ভালোই চলতে ছিল, সিদ্ধশ্বর কর্মচারী রাম সাগর আর বিবেকানন্দ বলে দিয়ে সভাটাকে বন্ধ করে দিল। প্রভুপাদ ওখান থেকে টেলিগ্রাম দিলেন যে আজ আমার লাখ কোটি পার্টিকে তারপরে প্রভুপাদ নিজের তাৎপর্যে আর বেশ ভালোভাবে দিলেন যে বিবেকানন্দ আর রবীন্দ্রনাথ ঠাকুর আমাদের ভারতীয় সংস্কৃতিকে গ্রহণ করেন, তারা অন্য কথা বলে, যারা আত্মার কিরকম হয় মঙ্গল হয়। প্রভুপাদ বললেন যে সে আমার লাখ টাকার প্রশিক্ষণ করে দিল, তিনি গুরু মহারাজের সঙ্গে ভিক্ষা যেতেন, কোন সময় তো ভিক্ষা দিয়েছেন ওই কোন জায়গা থেকে যেখানে প্রথম বর্ষ তুমি ছেলে লোক ছেলে মানুষ, আমি বড় আমি বড় ভাই, উনি বলছেন যে না প্রভু আপনি বড় দাদা, আমি আপনার ছোট ভাই, আমি বড় ভাই, এই জন্য কাড়াকাড়িকে করে আবার শেষে উনি বড়টা নিয়ে আসলেন গুরু মহারাজকে ছোট। আমাদের গুরু মহারাজের অপ্রকাটের সময় আমরা তাহাকে ডাকলাম, তিনি নিজের সাক্ষাতে সামনেতে সমাধি প্রদান করান আর আমাদের গৌড়ীয় বেদান্ত সমিতির স্ট্রাকচার করে দিয়ে আর তিনি সব বেঁধে দিলেন। গুরু মহারাজকে লিখে গিয়েছেন যে পূজ্যপাদ বামন মহারাজ উনার পরে সভাপতি আচার্য আর বাকি ওই শান্তি মহারাজ আমাকে ভাইস প্রেসিডেন্ট, এই বিক্রম মহারাজকে জেনারেল সেক্রেটারি, পর্যটক মহারাজকে দুটি পা ভেঙে যাওয়াতে আমিও আর দুর্বল হয়েছি। গোস্বামী মহারাজের সম্বন্ধে তার শিষ্য রসানন্দ ব্রহ্মচারী কিছু বলল,
হরে কৃষ্ণ, টুমরো আওয়ার প্রোগ্রাম ইজ কাম অন এন্ড টুমরো ইজ ভেরি অস্পিশাস ডে, the Gurudev told, tomorrow is appearance day of one Krishnamur associate of Sri Prabhupada Santri Chakur named Sri Bhakti Siddhanta Goswami Maharaj. While joining Mok at the time of Prabhupada, he came and saw, oh, what a learned scholar. I am the foolish one here. He went like his resident and started to read law and he admitted law college. Yes, but he could intimacy with our Paramahansa Sadhguru Jagdishant Goswami Maharaj. Both of them born in present Bangladesh. And he respected Paramahansa so much. So Paramahansa went there and Paramahansa thought, if he will not come to Prabhupada very soon, generally has a degree from law college, then you get to attorney, then mentoring material award, somehow or other, I have to bring him back to Prabhupada. So our Prabhupada went to his village and make him understand and bring him to Prabhupada again. So he always respect our Prabhupada as his guardian and elder brother and Shiksha Guru. So after that, when he matured Brahmachari, one disciple of Prabhupada was named Nemi Maharaj. He went for teaching in Bangladesh. Sabha was going on very nicely, very big crowd. The Nemi Maharaj told, today, Siddha Swarup Brahmachari is something in the Andhrasthan assembly. And he was very straightforward. Never speak behind. What you have to speak, very straightforward. And he at the Vivekananda, Swami Vivekananda, and Rabindranath Thakur. And he comes to Vivekananda. Vivekananda is Vivek is intelligent, and Vivek is not intelligent at all. Why so? Now, I will explain later on. And Rabindranath Thakur, he has long beard. And India, one type of goat, they have long beard called Ramchagar. And he told him Ramchagar. Why? Because Vivekananda, he never preached Indian Vedic philosophy. Going in America, he lectured about 1 hour. He put in on a board, that board, one zero, and he preached about zero. Everything comes from zero. And America, they became mad after him. He became very fanatic about him. And Rabindranath Thakur, he stole him from Gita Sam's work. And transcribed in Bengali prose, like Bengali verse, and he got Nobel Prize. So this is for Kitchen, not for others. Only this is honored by Kitchen. Then all assembly became chaos. The thing is so, I don't want to listen anything from this Brahmachari. And he told Ramakrishna Mission, Murgi Mission. So at that time, there is not so much teaching about Gaudiya Math. All became very chaos and they do some chaotic activity. Chicken Mission. So then, Nemi Maharaj sent a telegram to Prabhupada. Oh Prabhupada, our teaching was very nice, going so smooth. Siddha Swarup Brahmachari spoil everything. He told that Vivekananda and Ramchagar. Prabhupada, don't worry, I am coming. And today, Siddha Swarup Brahmachari wished for me and behalf of me for millions of dollars. So don't worry, I am coming very soon. Then Prabhupada came there. And he made understand the whole assembly what Siddha Swarup Brahmachari means, our beloved Siddha Goswami Maharaj. And Prabhupada made them understand that this world never come from zero and never go in zero. If it is zero, then who is instructing to others? Zero and zero no value at all, so why to instruct others? It's completely anti of basic philosophy. And Rabindranath Thakur also, he is followers of Raja Ramon by the time, the scholar of Brahma Samaj. Prabhupada make understand very nicely, all so assembly come and quiet, and they bound to follow Prabhupada's philosophy. After that, Buddha told, once our Param Gurudev and Buddha Siddhanti Maharaj went for marketing, and they made so many vegetables, and they put 2 sacks, one bigger and a smaller. Our Param Guru told, I am bigger than you, I am senior to you, and I am in age also senior to you, so I shall take a big sack, and you are junior to me, and junior in age also, so you take a smaller one. Buddha said, no, you are my senior, you are like my guru, how I shall keep the big burden? I shall take big one, you can take a smaller one. They know, I take a bigger one. Who is in the sidebar, they said, how crazy are they? We want to take a smaller one, progress on burden, and they are fighting for to take a big burden. Somehow other, Buddha Siddhanti Maharaj, in Prince Palakur, they appeared to the smaller one and to the bigger one. They came back to Mott. Then Gurudev told, when our Palakur, he appeared from this world, that they decide, Srila Gurudev, my Guru Maharaj, Pushtava Trinka Maharaj, decided him to come. And he came, and he all came all for Gauravedanta Samiti. Our beloved Param Gurudev told my Guru Maharaj to be president and acharya. After that, Sri Siddhanti Maharaj, he told, and in presence of him, he arranged everything, Samadhi, over, how to do, he teach everything to them, and told, Srila Bhaskaran Narayan Maharaj to be vice president, and Srila Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada to be general secretary, and Srila Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada Maharaj to be chief superintendent. So in this way, he did so nice framework. The structure was so nice and so strong, it was going on very nicely. After some time, with the interest of time, our Param Arhata Guru Parvarma and Param Pujava Trikram Maharaj disappeared from this world, the three pillars of Gauravedanta Samiti. Now we have told him to their ourselves, I became Vidya, then I give up Gauravedanta Samiti, and now I am going so nicely. So, now we have told, tomorrow we go to Tambavan, it will be very long day, about to come back after 6 o'clock, so there is no time to glorify about him. So his disciple, our Jarasan who is present here, gives me something and gives me offering to Srila Siddhanti Goswami Maharaj. And tomorrow we go to Bhajan Thali. Hare Krishna should go for cow grazing, and there Mata is to send so many things, putting that place to take picnic. So I'm requesting you all, take something to offer there and you can distribute among most of us. Hare Krishna. Kalapara Kishini Samyani Devan, Bhajan Thali Dev. Someone can get fruit, snacks, sweet, etc. So hot women, so misty women, it's a B11. So in progress of the hand, behind the hand, here are the original villages of the essay.
অত্যন্ত বিদ্বান লোক ছিলেন। প্রথমে তিনি খানা বই প্রকাশিত করলেন। বৃহৎ ভগবতামৃত বিন্দু বিন্দু কলা ভগবতামৃতের কিরণ তাহার ব্যাখ্যা বিবৃতি সহিত তারপরে তাহার জ্যেষ্ঠ গুরু ভ্রাতা ভক্তি ভাতু মহারাজ তিনি পদ্মে বিদ্যাভূষণের গীতা ভাষ্য অনুবাদ আর এইসব করেছেন বিবৃতি কাহিনী তাহাকে আবার প্রকাশিত করে প্রুফ ইত্যাদি করে আবার তিনি ভক্তি সোনার সম্পর্কে ঠাকুর টিকা আর তাহার টিকার অনুবাদ আর তাহার বিবৃতি দিয়ে তাহাকে প্রকাশ করে শুধু তাই না আমাদের বলতে বিদ্যাভূষণের গোবিন্দ ভাষ্য তাহার বিবৃতি তাহার অনুভাষ্য এইসব অনুবাদ করে তাহার নিজস্ব একটা পাণ্ডিত্যপূর্ণ বিবৃতি তাহার দিয়েছে এরকম ভাবে আরো ইংলিশ কেন কঠ আরো মানুষ ইত্যাদি পরিষদ দিয়েছে এই জন্য উদ্ধার সম্ভব অদ্ভুত গ্রন্থ বিশ্বনাথ চক্রবর্তী ঠাকুরের টিকা তার বিবৃতি সমেত বহুটা দিয়েছে বহু অমূল্য আমাদের সম্পত্তি রেখে দিয়েছে তার চরণে আমি পুনঃ পুনঃ পুষ্পাঞ্জলি
হরে কৃষ্ণ হি ওয়াজ এ গ্রেট লার্নড স্কলার অ্যান্ড হি পাবলিশ সো মেনি বুকস ফার্স্ট অফ অল হি পাবলিশ বিন্দু কিরণ কণা মিন্স ভক্তি স্বামী সিন্ধু বিন্দু সূর্য বিমণি কিরণ অ্যান্ড গ্রেট ভাগবত কণা লেটার অন শ্রী গুরুদেব ট্রান্সলেট ইন হিন্দি and publishing and that is available in English also. And moreover, he published and his god brother, Srila Bhaktivedanta Bharati Maharaj, he published the commentary of Srila Bhaktivedanta Bhaktivedanta about Gita and Govinda Bhasa, the commentary of Vedanta Sutra in Madhya Sampradaya. 4 volume. And now Gurudev is busy to publish in Hindi and English. Work has been started already about that. Moreover, he gave us 11 Upanishads. Isha, Kena, Kautav, Vaitarya, Vaitarya, Mandukva, Mandukva, Chandrava, Keshavra, he published. And the commentary of Sri Vishnu Kaku about Gita and his own commentary. Moreover, he did Uttar Sangha. So, we are eternally indebted to him. And tomorrow, just immediately after Mangalarti, we will put Manjali here, then we will go to Vas for Kampavan. কালকে মঙ্গলারতির পরে ওনার পিছনে পুষ্পাঞ্জলি দেওয়া হবে। পুষ্পাঞ্জলি পরে আপনারা ইয়ার বাসে চলে যাবেন। কাল শুনে মঙ্গলারতিকে উপরান আমরা পুষ্পাঞ্জলি অর্পণ করেনকে আর সকল বাসে বাইরে ভারতীয় বাসের জন্য বলছি, 1 নম্বর বাস দেখেন অজিত হালদার, 2 নম্বর বাস বলরাম হালদার, 3 নম্বর বাস গোবিন্দ দাস অধিকারী, 4 নম্বর বাস মান্না দাস অধিকারী, 5 নম্বর বাস প্রহ্লাদ ব্রহ্মচারী, 6 নম্বর বাস রামকেশব ব্রহ্মচারী, 7 নম্বর বাস বলরাম ব্রহ্মচারী দেবী, 8 নম্বর বাস রাজেশ তিওয়ারি। প্রত্যেকে যে বাসে যাবেন টিকিট আর অনেক দূরে জার্নি তো দাঁড়িয়ে যেতে পারবেন না, যার টিকিট নাই তার বাসে যাওয়ার চেষ্টা করবেন না। যদি আমাদের সিট থাকে তখন আমরা নেব। जिनका टिकट नहीं है वो बस में चढ़ने का प्रयास न करें, तो हम लोग का जगह हो तो हम लोग ले सकते हैं। Whoever traveling with us, they go their own bus, don't change your buses. So if you have an extra room, then you can take others. Thank you for your cooperation.
We have just come. There will be outside list with who is in what bus. There are those who are interested in buses, go to your state buses, and also when you arrive, look on the list which will be posted outside tomorrow morning latest and check in which bus you will be. Also, one request, after prasadam, your leaflets, don't throw them here and there over the wall or anywhere around, because so many rats and other animals come and they take possession, they start to live in rooms everywhere. Put your leaflets in the garbage bins. There is everywhere bins where you can place them in. Thank you for your cooperation.
Hare Krishna, after our call, Pata Ekhada Khana Khalibana, Pata Khada Jona Amade Pran Rakha Chakana Khalibana, Rasta Rokare, Pata Yavala Kare Khalibana, Ura Amade Jomini Lokar Jomini Lokar Jomini Lokar Jomini Lokar প্রত্যেকে গ্রাম রাখলে তাহলে কোথায় ফেলবে না। কই প্রসাদ কে বাদ পত্তলি ধরতে আপনি কি কাল আমাদের জল খাবার জল খাইতে হবে। রঘুজ্য বাদ সিদ্ধান্ত গোস্বাই মহারাজের মহোৎসব প্রসাদ আমরা বিমলা কুটে পাবো। টুমারো উইল টেক ব্রেকফাস্ট প্রসাদ ভজন থালি অ্যান্ড ফেস্টিভাল অফ পরম পূজ্য সিদ্ধান্ত গোস্বাই মহারাজ গ্র্যান্ড বিশ্বী দ্য ব্যাংক অফ বিমলা কুটে। হরে কৃষ্ণ।